The government remains concerned by queues for fuel and is working on long-term financing mechanisms with the RBZ, which will see the supply gaps being eliminated over time. I've said that the issue of fuel is a matter of national concern. It requires a national effort. I've seen some people dropping this task on my shoulders alone, or on the shoulders of government alone. All of us here have a responsibility. Those that use fuel, those that import it, those of us who are in government, we all need to play a role in coming up with a lasting solution to this problem, so that we reenact the dignity of our people who spend times in queues. We don't believe that it's solely an issue of foreign currency. We also want to look on the other side as to what can be done. Issues of solar need to come into play. Alternative transport. In other countries, highly developed countries, bicycles are a key means of transportation. So we need to have a raft of measures that we discuss and agree as a country. And if we do not agree and the sector is not amenable to self-regulation, we will of course do what is necessary, elect the necessary legal frameworks that will help us ensure that our mandate is protected. I've made it very clear that we expect ZERA to take charge of its regulatory function, just like other government regulatory authorities guard jealously their mandates. We have a duty to ensure that there is continuous supply of fuel and that whatever is available is not abused. And it is the duty of ZERA to develop the necessary frameworks in conjunction with all of us so that we come up with a framework that ensures business continuity. We are not going to engage in blame game, but it's a national matter that we must sit down and come up and resolve speedily. Government is also working closely with power utilities to ensure that there is increased power generation from different sources other than Kariba station, including imports. On the other hand, government would like to see ZERA playing a pivotal role in terms of increasing public awareness, information dissemination, and consumer education on efficient use of energy products, including uptake of renewable energy products. So we are looking to an extremely proactive and fast-moving ZERA that is fully aware of what is happening in the economy and what we need to ensure that there is business continuity in our country and that we do not have erratic and perennial fuel shortages. Key to your certification is the ability to meet your commitment to your customer charter and your stakeholder needs. Responsiveness is key in the Second Republic, and the Ministry would like to see proactive institutions who are strategic in addressing the country's challenges. Excuse me. The issue of good governance is a must, and I personally am a stickler for good governance. Smart in otangira kumusoro. We expect men and women of integrity who are in ZERA and our parastatals to operate professionally and not to cause harm to the public or to the public person. And I want to make it very clear that where there is disobedience of the law, or negligent behavior by those that have been entrusted by government to serve on our boards or to serve on our parastate house, we will have recourse against you personally based on your conduct. So corporate governance is very, very key, and with this certification, we expect that everyone who is a player in the industry will also have proper corporate governance. And ZERA is at liberty to develop rules and regulations that help this particular sector to fall into line. This is very, very critical. I therefore challenge you to lead as government's advisor and policy implementation institution in coming up with long-term solutions to our challenges by intensifying your research and development function in collaboration with institutions of research and higher learning. I said earlier on that we need a composite effort that helps us to come up with a solution to a national challenge. We need our tertiary institutions, experts in these areas, to be able to give us advice so that we benefit from the totality of the skills and knowledge that we've got as a country. So this is a public call to our tertiary institutions to come on board, and I'll be happy to sit down with them so that they can give us advice on how we can deal with this matter. It's a very, very urgent issue. I also want to challenge those that are in the technology industry to say to them, tell us what it is that we can do to take advantage of current and modern technologies to manage the fuel situation in our country. What is it that we need to do on the basis of the problems that we know? We all know what has been happening. We've had foreign trucks coming in, buying 15,000 liters and so forth, and driving out and going to sell it. We need to be able to track our fuel. Where has it gone to? Who has taken it where? A service station that got so many liters, did it sell those liters there? Is the payment in the formal financial system? So we are going to be having a lot of discussions with the Reserve Bank around those issues to make sure that we have a proper professional fuel industry. So this collaboration should anticipate and proactively come up with long-term strategies to enhance energy security. As a new minister, I expect to see results and strategies that resolve our challenges and proposals to restructure the sector for performance. We are not an oil-producing country, and this is not our choice. It's got one variable that we cannot do anything about, and we know that power is very, very expensive, and it requires foreign currency, which is in extreme short supply. This means that we have got to take measures that take into cognizance our current situation and how we can make sure that we continue to function. I would like to challenge all present to seriously consider electric vehicles, bicycles. I thought you were going to clap for bicycles. Bicycles. This requires that we cooperate with the Minister of Transport, for example. These are new things, and the necessary legal frameworks have got to be initiated. And ZERA being the regulatory authority in an area that is so key to our economy should be able to initiate this and talk to colleagues in other government departments, particularly the Minister of Transport, so that the necessary legal framework for electric vehicles is actually there. It's the trend. In some countries, they're actually abandoning buses that work on diesel. And if our problem is one of foreign currencies, as we say, then we need to consider other modes of transportation or energy that are not as consumptive of foreign currency as possible. So this is, I think, a challenge to all of us, not just Zera. We can all cycle to work. For some of us, it's healthy. It is healthy, I can tell you, and it's cheap on the pocket. We'd also like to expect the electrical vehicles to be charged from renewable sources. So we would like this intermodality to work. So if an electric vehicle, we don't want it to be charged with Zesa per se. But we should have in our minds the fact that we have lots of sun, and people should be able to get their energy for their vehicle from the sun. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great honor that I take this opportunity to heartily congratulate Zera once again for this historic milestone. And I also want specifically to thank Dr. Agatsikwa for the work that you've done in bringing us this far. And I hope that you continue to collaborate with Zera as these standards cascade to all stakeholders and operators. I think if we achieve that, we'll have done a great good. I wish Dr. Kosa and fellow board members, management and staff all the best as they are ushered into the world of ZW ISO 9001-2015 QMS certified organizations. But I also want to say this is the beginning of the real work. The certificate should not be hung on the wall. We want to see it working practically in compliance with the evaluations that were done. Let me end by reminding Zera that this is just the beginning. And there is need to sustain the culture of excellent service beyond this celebration. It is my fervent hope that Dr. Kosa and their team will ensure that Zera systems get certified also in the near future. I want to close by repeating my challenge to all of you, that let's congregate against the challenges that we've got around power, around fuel. I believe that it's not a matter that is insurmountable. It is within our power to resolve the current issues, provided we put the national interest at the forefront.